Greetings. If you are Muslim, I think you are very sincere in your commitment to Mohammed and Islam. But I also think your sincerity has blinded you into wanting claims that seem to support Islam to be true. Do you want to follow Islam because you follow Islam, or because you think it is true? How sincere is your actual respect for Almighty God? Sadly, Islam's claims are nearly always false, based on bad logic or fabricated inventions. Let's look carefully and critically at one of Deedat's most original and logically flawed teachings.
He says, I have yet many things to say unto you, but he cannot bear them now. Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak from himself. But what things shall he hear, that shall he speak, and he shall declare unto you the things that are to come. He shall glorify me. 8 masculine pronouns in one verse.
So Deedat has just recited a passage from the Bible. Then Deedat makes the following claim.
8 masculine pronouns in one verse.
8 masculine pronouns in one verse. Here, listen again.
For what things shall he hear, that shall he speak, and he shall declare unto you the things that are to come. He shall glorify me. 8 masculine pronouns in one verse.
8 masculine pronouns in one verse. What if I tell you that whole statement is entirely wrong? First, the content Deedat recites is not from one verse. If I were you, I would not believe me just cause I said so. You believe Deedat just cause he said so. And he was completely wrong, as I am about to irrefutably prove. Deedat reads from the King James translation. John 16:13. Howbeit when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth, for he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come. That is one verse. It is the whole verse. And it is only 7 pronouns. Please pause the video and count and recount for yourself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
8 masculine pronouns in one verse.
He's wrong that he read from one verse. He read more than one verse. And nope, there are only 7 pronouns in one verse. His whole claim is wrong. And from this absolutely flawed assertion, Deedat then draws an even more faulty conclusion.
8 masculine pronouns in one verse. I say, it ill befits a ghost. You agree? That is a man, a man, a man, a man.
I say it ill befits a ghost. We agree. It is a man, a man, a man, a man.
Now I want you to pay close attention to something Deedat does in this entire argument. In the Greek, the word spirit of the phrase Holy Spirit is in the Greek the word pneuma. In fact, it is translated both Holy Spirit and Holy Ghost. It serves Deedat's agenda to cloud your awareness from the phrase Holy Spirit. To do this, Deedat emphasizes the phrase Holy Ghost, drawing out the long O. pushing ghost into your mind, he will then try to change spirit into prophet, dropping the holy prefix. He has just poured his poor foundational claim, 8 masculine pronouns in one verse. Get ready for his dog-piled jihad, adding more nonsense to the pile of manure.
8 masculine pronouns in one verse. I say, it ill befits a ghost. You agree? That is a man, a man, a man, a man. 8 times. There is not another verse in the whole Bible with 8 masculine pronouns or 8 feminine gender or 8 neuter genders. There isn't.
8 times. There is not another verse in the whole Bible with 8 masculine pronouns or 8 feminine gender or 8 neuter genders. There isn't. And he gestures with a big sweep of his hand.
Man, a man, a man. 8 times. There is not another verse in the whole Bible with 8 masculine pronouns or 8 feminine gender or 8 neuter genders. There isn't.
He might as well have said, there isn't because I say there isn't. And you Muslims are too lazy and too stupid to even bother to check. You'll believe anything I say and never think twice about it. Deedat adds more to the pile.
Pronouns or 8 feminine gender or 8 neuter genders. There isn't. This is a unique verse for a unique personality, Muhammad.
Unique. Being the only one of its kind. Unlike anything else. This is a unique verse. Being the only one of its kind. Unlike anything else. For a unique personality, Mohammed. Deedat is hoping to make the assertion that if this verse is unique, then the uniqueness is a subtle shadow of Mohammed, howbeit an invented, imaginary shadow of Mohammed on a moonless, cloudy night. Deedat was wrong. There are 8 pronouns. There are only 7. Deedat was wrong. His text was from one verse. It came from 2. Any takers willing to bet a verse with 8 masculine pronouns is unique? Thanks to a brother in the body of Christ, nicer person, who was a good Berean, he sent me a list nearly 3 years ago. My time has flown, brother. 1 Kings 16:11. And it came to pass when he sat began to reign, as soon as he sat on his throne, that he slew all the house of Baasha. He left him not one that pisseth against a wall, neither of his kinfolks nor of his friends. That's 8. I find this first example fascinating, because we know Muhammad squatted to pee like a, well, not like a man. Did you count the pronouns? Did you notice there were 8 masculine pronouns? Please pause the video and recount for yourself. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In logic, this is called disproving an assertion by counterexample. A Muslim says, a woman is too stupid to drive a car. And out walks Courtney Force, Danica Patrick, and dozens of winning female race car drivers. Their example proves the initial statement false by demonstrating the existence of counterexamples to the statement. Likewise, a claim like the following, that this is a unique verse for a unique personality, Muhammad, is proven false if even only one other verse meets the same test. But that is only one verse, you might protest. 2 Kings 4:34, and he went up and lay upon the child and put his mouth on his mouth, and his eyes upon his eyes, and his hands upon his hands. And he stretched himself upon the child, and the flesh of the child waxed warm. That is 9 masculine pronouns in 1 verse. Surely, this must be a more unique verse. Want to claim this is Mohammed too? But some desperate Muslim may claim it is not 8, and that is okay. 2 Chronicles 24:25. And when they were departed from him, for they left him in great disease, his own servants conspired against him for the blood of the sons of Jehoiada the priest, and slew him on his bed, and he died. And they buried him in the city of David, and they buried him not in the sepulcher of the kings. That is 2 verses with 9 masculine pronouns in 1 verse. I guess 9 masculine pronouns is not unique and cannot be proof of Muhammad. I was so sure 9 would be more than 8. Isaiah 46:11. They bear him upon the shoulder, they carry him and set him in his place, and he standeth. From his place shall he not remove. Yea, one shall cry unto him, yet can he not answer, nor save him out of his trouble? Oh my God, I ran out of fingers. 11 masculine pronouns. That is 3 more, 3 better than 8. Isaiah 53:10. Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him. He hath put him to grief. When thou shalt make his soul an offering for sin, he shall see his seed. He shall prolong his days, and the pleasure of the Lord shall prosper in his hand. Another verse with 9 masculine pronouns. Ezekiel 3:20. Again, when a righteous man doth turn from his righteousness and commit iniquity, and I lay a stumbling block before him, he shall die. Because thou hast not given him warning, he shall die in his sin. And his righteousness which he has done shall not be remembered, but his blood will I require at thine hand. That's 9 again. Daniel 5:21. And he was driven from the sons of men, and his heart was made like the beasts, and his dwelling was with the wild asses. They fed him with grass like oxen, and his body was wet with the dew of heaven, till he knew that the Most High God ruled the kingdom of men, and that he appointed over it whomsoever he will. That is a 3rd verse with 8 masculine pronouns, looking a little less than unique to me. Daniel 8:25. And through his policy also he shall cause craft to prosper in his hand, and he shall magnify himself in his heart, and by peace shall destroy many. He shall also stand up against the prince of princes, but he shall be broken without hand. Another verse with 8 masculine pronouns. What's that count now? 4? So listen to Deedat's argument again, this time knowing what you now know. The verse does not have 8 pronouns in it. The scripture he recites is more than 1 verse. A verse with 8 masculine pronouns is not unique. In sports, that is called an offer, as in 0 or 0 for all attempts. In baseball, 3 strikes and you're out. Not one piece of Deedat's claim is defensible, brother. The argument of a unique verse tragically demonstrates Deedat's utter contempt for Muslims. There is no gentle way to put this, my Muslim brother or sister. Deedat thinks you are a silly, gullible child, without the curiosity or respect for God to check what he told you. I invite you to listen to the truth and check every verse I quoted and every claim I make. God's truth fears no question, brother. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.